that, like them sorts of things.
Yeah, 3 o'clock in the morning.
I do actually have like uncles in music and stuff like that. There's a group called Shut Up and Dance.
Oh, and, you what did you say?
Yeah, yeah.
Really?
Yeah, yeah. A lot of people don't know. Yeah, man. But the two guys in there, there's PJ and Smiley, and my uncles Cole and Phillips.
So fuck
out. Both
of
them are my uncles. Stop. That's mad, isn't it?
Not now. Yeah, man. Yeah, man. Not so, now.
Yeah, man. So yeah. That they actually at my granddad's house and that when we were younger. KillerKellerOfficial.com.
Street Culture TV.
Beatbox created.
Killer Keller.
And we're here to talk about world music and street culture.
Killer Keller Podcast.
Saying Killer Keller Podcast live and direct, central London, or central as you could be, should be, choose to be. You don't want to be anywhere else, baby. But come on, you saw the brochure, you know what I mean? You know what you're in for. Big shout out to the shares and carers, people have been spotting us from day one. And if you want more of the good observations and soundtracks to the streets, you get a television app, free download, iPhone, Android for your sport and arts, where it's mini docs, big docs, mini mixes. Big mixes and then the tourist podcast that you love to hate, loving most of the time. Killer Keller here, what's good? Hey, listen, we've got a special guest inside the place, without question. Hey, an original from the grime scene and beyond, but a little bit deeper than that. We're going to get into some really tall tales and long stories. We're talking about grime, we're talking about history, we're talking about the mighty shiesty in the building. Get
in! Big up, man, big up.
How are we, gentlemen?
Yeah, man, I'm good, man, I'm all right.
Yeah, what do you
mean? Man.
So what's the scoop? I mean, we chatted a little bit before, to be fair.
Yeah, a little bit.
The levels of intel with this man. I mean, I get the impression that when it comes to grime, it felt, just by observation, I understand.
Yeah, yeah.
An entry hole for you. Because you're an artist.
Yeah, yeah. I try to do bits and bobs. It's a weird one with me because I do a lot of radio. And a lot of radio based around grime. And obviously, a lot of the tunes are going to be grime. Mm. But I try and do bits and bobs of everything. But my I think my downfall is I don't really put out a lot of music, so a lot of people don't know that. Yeah. But in my house, I wrote all sorts of stuff from like reggae things to rap things to grime things to just whatever, really, man. Mm. I just like music, innit? Music's good stuff. So wherever it goes, it goes.
It's funny, isn't it? Like when I think about entry holes into scenes.
Yeah,
and it's almost like the train's moving and you just got to jump on it.
Mm-hmm.
And it's all about timing, isn't it? It's all about timing and how that works in the grand scheme. If it's the most relevant music of its time, you really got to pick up your pace and move with the motions, haven't you?
Yeah, a lot of it is age, isn't it? People fall into things. I mean, like a lot of the youngers now fall into like the drill thing and all that because of their age.
Mm.
They haven't really got people around them. There is a few. There's some young ones coming through and stuff, like big up people like Duppy and people like that. They're younger and they're doing their thing and they're carrying the genre, which is actually good for everyone because even the older lot, it still kind of keeps it relevant.
Yeah.
I mean, because minus the people that get really big and blow, like the Skeptas, the Dizzys, the Getzes and people like that, a lot of the back end of a genre can tend to just kind of fade off a little bit as a new genre comes in. Mm. It's like I was born 86, so I stepped in just on the back end of old school garbage.
Big shout out to the old 86 crew, you know you are, you're on the grid. Big up.
Yeah. Shouldn't have even slapped out that
see,
age.
I see,
but it's there.
You need to do the math, just comment, say what's up.
Yeah, man, so yeah, that's what happened. So I came in off the back of like the old school garbage, and now I see my uncles and that coming in off the back of like jungle and things like that, so... Yeah, man, so that's what happens. I just ended up there.
Oh, so what, your uncles and relations were like deep in the drum and bass thing? They were into it?
I saw them coming in from raves and that, like them sorts of things.
Yeah, 3 o'clock in the morning.
I do actually have like uncles in music and stuff like that. There's a group called Shut Up and Dance.
Oh, and, you what do you say?
Yeah, yeah.
Really?
Yeah, yeah. A lot of people don't know. Yeah, man. But the two guys in there, there's PJ and Smiley, and my uncles Cole and Phillips.
Still, fuck
both of them are my uncles.
Stop.
That's mad,
it.
Isn't it?
Not now.
No, man. Yeah, man.
Not
so,
now.
Yeah, man. So yeah. That they actually at my granddad's house and that when we was younger, they'd be mixing a lot along with my uncle Andy, a few other uncles and that and yeah, that was how I kind of learnt to mix off that. My younger brother actually taught me. They taught him because he was interested and I weren't. And then we ended up with a pair of 1210s and then my brother taught me. And I ended up DJing and it went from there still, yeah.
So you DJ first?
Yeah. For a little while, man. I was... I say a little while. I maybe learned to DJ from about, maybe, I want to say 12, 13. I was trying. Because I had like one of my uncle's ex-partners as well. Like, she was getting rid of her record. She gave me like a load of like drum and bass and stuff like that. So it was all like all the Choppers, Wolf and
Lighter and them sorts of things.
So I'm indoors with them sorts of bangers and I'm just getting on that. And then the old school Gavage came in. Then I'm going Rhythm Division, Pause for Music and Uptown and everywhere. Getting my own stuff. Yeah, yeah.
Black Market, Bang Bang.
Yeah, exactly. I just ended up in that age group, like we were saying. And because I already had the 12 tens, they were like probably the best decks I could have had at the time. Even up to now, I'd say for vinyl, they're the one, aren't they? 100%. And so I just kind of got in it, man. Didn't drink and smoke, save my pocket money and that, and just went out there and just records.
Even still to this day, no drink, no smoke?
No. I keep away from it, man. I wouldn't be able to breathe quick enough if I smoked, man.
What's your vice? Give me something that, I mean, we did mention tea, and I'm a sucker for sweet shit. You know what I mean,
mate? It's the same, man. It's actually nuts because I like all types of food, but I haven't eaten meat for about 10, 11 years, and then I become vegan about 6 years ago. So even then, it was like worse. Because I say worse is better, but it's worse for like in regards to things I want to pick at, because a lot of the things I can't even have anyway. Yeah, yeah. But now they're like catering to all that, which is putting me off of it a bit. But
because you know what, why is that from the purest point of view? Like,
do you know what it is? At the end of the day, you got to take accountability in it. So anything, if I feel the things becoming less pure, then that's because I am catering to that. Do you know what I mean? And I'm becoming a consumer of that rubbish, really. I should just get fresh art as everything else gets worse. Do you know what I mean? So the same way I stepped away from the meat, I should be able to step away from all the rubbish and the food and that.
Isn't it funny how the pendulum swings on industry? So that, okay.
It's money, isn't it? Yeah. Everything's money, man. Yeah. Everything's money. They see something, the percentage went up. I think like 1% of the world is vegan or something, and then they're just like, oh, mate, we ain't going to miss out on 1%. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. Almost makes the damage that's done for the meat industry not avoid when the pendulum goes so far towards
it. That's another
conversation. But it's really interesting. So disciplinary, like music was really the thing that you were, and you didn't subscribe to any of those other kind of extracurricular activities.
I wouldn't say any of them. Yeah, maybe. I mean, everyone has their ups and downs. When you're growing up, you're trying to find yourself. You try to fit in. You try to be who you are, as well as who your mum wants you to be, as well as everything. Do you know what I mean? And somewhere in the middle of all of that, there's a kind of grey area where you just kind of end up being. But I think as I've got older, I'm not really one to care what other people think as much, and I just do what I want.
Hence why
I say I don't release a lot, because I might just get the urge to go radio and go and do something, or freestyle or something like that. But when I get back and I want to not do that, and I might want to play a game or go out with my kids or do whatever, I'll just do all that stuff. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. You're quite weird. Just off the bat, the observation is you're very, you're very open, very worldly. There isn't a habitual side to you that's, you know, because with people, musicians especially. Artists, rappers, there's this urge to be busy for the sake of being busy. Because it's almost, I guess there's a sense of peer pressure, maybe.
I think in the music industry, a lot of people think if you're not active, you're not relevant. Yeah. And to be fair, music's becoming so throwaway that, like I was saying, I've still got vinyls that are like 20 years old. Yeah. And to me, they still mean something. Mm. But someone could release a tune last month, and if you play it this month, they're like, I heard that last month. Yeah. So what? If the tune's good, it's good.
It's good.
Why can't it last 3-4 months and then fade out? Do you know what I mean? Why is it that, that's old, he's got something new? And then you got to always kind of better your last, which you should always be trying to do anyway.
Mm.
But the pressure shouldn't be there. Like, I should be able to put out a poem mid-time if I want, and then just go back and do another tune. Like, who's to tell me I can't do that?
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Where does that pressure come from? Because you clearly don't have it. Like,
no, I'm just one of these people. I don't really care what anyone thinks of me, to be honest. I've always, since that kind of grey area of wondering about things, and I've got to have this tracksuit, or I've got to have that, or like when you're growing up, and since I stepped out of that, I really couldn't care. So for me, it doesn't matter as much. I can understand why it's there, maybe, but I don't know. It's not for me, man. I don't really care about all that.
Shiesty. If you haven't checked out this lyricist, please do. It's very important that you do to get context of what I'm about to say. Never have I, I spoke to Argue. Big up DJ Argue. All fucking day. That's my guy.
Every single time.
Not to mention the kinship that DJs have with MCs and vice versa. The fact that you started in DJing and you're able to transfer skill sets to MCing.
Yeah.
There's a relationship there. Argue with the other DJs. But, and I said this to Argue, never have I heard an MC genuinely from the UK that kind of epitomises his name. It's like your vocal delivery and the way you spit.
Yeah.
The timbre, the tone.
Yeah.
It's Shiesty.
Yeah, you reckon, yeah.
For the name itself, I don't know another MC that has that almost... No offence.
Yeah, go on.
Like, almost like a feral tone.
Yeah.
And when you say the name Shiesty,
it's
like, yeah. It's almost like you're...
Yeah, like it fits.
Yeah, it fits.
Yeah.
Never heard anything like it, bro.
Oh, that's cool. Yeah, I've never heard that, but I like that. Props. I rate that. Wicked, man.
Yeah.
I got a lot of people telling me I'm like a... I sound like an old school MC, but they're like, you got like an old school grime kind of thing, but it fits now, and I get all of that. But yeah, I've never really heard that. It's really weird, because when I was growing up, when I was younger, you're saying about like the tone of the voice and all of that stuff. I hated my voice. When I was young, I didn't used to really speak that much. I was quite a in the corner, like I'm talking like young, not in school, like bully things and all that, none of that. But when I was younger, I just never really liked my voice at all. And
why is that?
I don't know. I never really liked it. I'm not really a fan of it. Like when I listen back to like a voice note or something, I don't know. It's weird, but I kind of listened to it on a tune once and I thought, you know what? If you was going through a radio station and you heard like half a second and flicked past, you would know it was me.
That's what it is. Because
it stands out. Yeah. So it's got that kind of, you see like Dizzy's got like his own kind of thing or double and they kind of got like a certain tone to their voice and that. So I don't know. I just thought, yeah, man, just take it and can't change it. You know what I mean? You've got to work with it. So it is what it is. But as I get older, like I said, it don't really bother me like that.
As you get older, it's like a fine wine. Your voice, if treated right, all of a sudden those depths and nuances in your voice, they come of age.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And you hear that with a lot of garage MCs, to be fair, and drum and bass.
Yeah.
Like they don't change in their dynamics of range, but it's just the way they, it's just an energy.
Yeah.
They're older. They've got more. It's a class, isn't it?
There is to a degree. Sometimes it's weird because I'll just be speaking and people like, bloody sound like you're about to start speaking. I'm just like, oh, combo. But they just say you just kind of go with some kind of whimsical kind of thing or something.
Pattern. It's almost happens. Like you start patterning in.
Yeah. Probably subconsciously, maybe syllable canting in my combo. Like, I don't know. Like, yeah. But yeah, it happens.
It's funny, isn't it? When you get deep into, because these are the deep conversations that I guess are thought through, but they don't always appear in conversation like that.
No. You know what I mean? It's true. Yeah.
It's a beautiful idea that that you're able to, you're just doing what you do, and then all of a sudden suddenly your words start patterning into bar simulation, and next thing people are like, oh, you're MC.
Yeah. It's nuts. Yeah. It happens, man. It's so weird, isn't it?
Yeah, it's bonkers. And it still falls in line with what's going on nowadays, you know. Nowadays being, particularly with grime, I'll explain a little bit more in detail where my mind has gone over the last few days, because I find it interesting. Chipmunk.
Yeah.
Back in the day, I'll say loosely back in the day, he did the stuff with T.I. and he had that whole thing pop off.
Yeah.
And the reception was... I guess from a scene point of view, it was salute, well done, you're doing good. Chipmunk is our guy anyway. But the project was lukewarm.
Yeah.
Because maybe it was too early.
Yeah.
Because now when you got Stormzy, and I don't know, I mean, I'm no professional when it comes to this, but I don't hear grime in the same way I first heard Stormzy when he emerged.
Okay.
So what's the difference between him and Chipmunk? Why does time have to create these differences
kind of thing. I think there's a few things. Stormzy first coming about was not too long ago. Chipmunk was ages ago. I think the ages they maybe come through, because I remember going radio with Chipmunk when he was like young, like doing sets with people like Impact or Dot Rotten, Dark Horse. Like there was Axe FM and places like this, and people would go and people would just be there. Do you know what I mean? People come from all different crews, whether it was like Red Hot or like whatever I was in at the time or anything. Do you know what I mean? And people come together and go and do things then. But Chipmunk was always good then. I feel like he got his, he got pushed early.
Mm.
I don't really ever recall hearing like shit verses or anything from him. He's always been good.
Always been tough.
He's always been cold. I can't remember what project that was on, to be honest. So I can't really...
It was so off the radar, wasn't it? It was such a mystical...
I remember hearing tunes around that time, like you said, like with the TI thing and stuff like that, but I can't remember the project itself, so maybe that says it all, I don't know. But Stormzy nowadays, I think Stormzy's quite a good image. Like, he's a big guy, he's like, he come through with like a certain certain thirst for it, and I feel like it kind of worked. Every artist's just going to come through on their own thing and just do what they do and whatever happens. But I think a lot of grime was radio-based back then as well. So Rinse FM, Axe FM, or Deja, Flavor, whatever it was at the time, Temptation, anything. Mm. People would actually lock in, because if we're 16, everyone that's listening is 16. So they're getting home, they're doing homework, and they're locking in, do you know what I mean? And names kind of built up in the area and then got bigger and done whatever. But now I don't think radio's as much of a thing. People have got Spotify and that. They want to listen to the songs they already like.
Mm.
No one really wants to find out new music. And to find out new music from an old genre, they're probably thinking, if I want to listen to something new, I'll listen to something current. And I feel like there are a lot of big channels that I think could probably help in pushing it. And making grime, like, because I saw something the other day, someone put up like top 10 bangers this week or this month or whatever, and every single tune was like a drill tune. And I'm thinking to myself, mate, like, Cruz Leone just released a tune called, I think it's OT Trips or something. And and it had like, I think it had 9 million on it. It had XP. XP is one of the coldest lyricists that I think we have in the UK, bro. I think he's proper top tier. Like, I used to look at my grime list and think, all right, Double and Monkey at the top and blah, blah, blah. But he's definitely just straight in at my top 10, probably with like a Sox as well. Sox is cold.
Yeah.
Certain people that I've paid more of attention to this time around. SK is like one of the sickest lyricists I know. There's a guy called Charlie Trees, wicked as well.
See, and comment below, Google that shit. Like, if you're new to the scene.
Honestly, man.
I mean, I'm as new as you. Get in fuck involved. Like, we're talking to a reputable person. And do you think the reason why drill has got that spotlight is trend? Do you think they're trying to assimilate and capture the essence of, like, youth and that attention?
Yeah. I think there's that. I think their beats are cold as well.
Yeah, the beats are cold.
I don't think, for me, I just don't think there's enough variation in it. I feel like everyone has the same kind of delivery, the same kind of style, the same kind of angle in their lyricism, the same kind of everything. And I feel like I could listen to a few different people and maybe not know the difference between each person until they said their area or something like that.
For real? I agree.
Yeah.
But then I also think of... like hip-hop in the 90s and how everything was boom-bap. It was called boom-bap for a reason, right?
Yeah, yeah.
And amen breaks in drum and bass. If it wasn't an amen, then it ain't drum. You know what I mean? So there are these trends, like the 808s and the, you know, the sort of snares, etc., that they use in any genres. And that shit's not new. You create a format and repeat. I love the beats on drill.
Yeah,
it's just the MCing. It comes down to the MCing, doesn't it?
Yeah, I think there are some really sick artists, but I think it's the same as anything. It's like when Funky House came about, it was like there were certain people that were really good and certain people that weren't. But I think if you get in something new, if there's only 100 tunes circulating, then it don't matter if you've got the 70th best one, because you can't run a set without playing like a whole rave without playing like 100 tunes. You ain't going to play the one the DJ's just played before. So therefore you get in no matter what. So I think when the drill thing was new, I think everyone was trying it, because as long as you were one of the first people in your area, I suppose, I'm assuming that they're going to get behind you anyway, because who else are they going to push if you're the only one doing it?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So that's my personal opinion. But like I said, I'm a bit like, I'm older, so I don't really know too much about that. I spat on like a drill beat myself, but it was with RK. It was actually RK's tune. Nice. I just got a verse on it. But I just done like my grime kind of thing on it. But because the beat is so spacey and all of that, you can actually hear what I'm saying a bit more than tune being cluttered.
Yeah, there's that. Yeah, isn't it?
Like I do like that. I think that's what I like about the tunes. You can deliver proper content on it and have people like pull apart, you know, double entendres and the similes and metaphors, and like they can notice everything. Do you know what I mean?
Such space to move. Yeah. You know what I mean? It's like saxophonist or trumpet player playing over top. It's just like lacing the whole thing.
Exactly. It's just like a melody, really, isn't it? We're just like empty kicks and snares and just some spaced out. It's like, it's kind of wicked, really.
Yeah.
It's good stuff.
Yeah. You mentioned there about selection.
Mm-hmm.
You mentioned about playlist, the DJ, the genre with funky house or... Yeah. Or, you know, we're dealing in tempos essentially. And MCs are, you know, to be the top of your game, you know, you want to be a fly on anything. But maybe, because my mind went to, if you're doing an hour and a half DJ set and bearing in mind there's going to be someone before you, someone after you, that may have played the similar sort of music.
Yeah, yeah.
It's inherent that you find like something, whether it be a couple of drill tunes with a couple of, you know, basically, you know, dubstep stuff, some bass music.
It's all around the 140 mark, although that can work.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. But if you don't find something new, I mean, you know, not many DJs take requests, by the way, but like if you start dropping too much drill, it's be like, play that, you know, and then you suddenly start carving your lane into that, when really what you're trying to do is just broaden the palette, isn't it?
Yeah, I feel every DJ has their own purpose, and I think a lot of DJs need to learn that as well. If you're on a show and there's 10 DJs, like, if you're the first one and you're warm up and, like, the place is empty, like, don't just slap out all the bangers else, like, that's for a little bit later, do you know what I mean? But that's from my personal thing. But at the same time, in something like, I don't know, something like Graham, you kind of can, because it's been around long enough, so you could play all the bangers from, like, the 2000s or whatever, and you won't even get a dent into it. Do you know what I mean? And then someone else can like find a little niche and do a little something in there. Do you know what I mean? That just makes you stand out. Otherwise, you're just another DJ playing tunes.
Does that blow your mind that grime has come so far? And like you say, you don't even scratch the surface, and you are a part of this tapestry.
Yeah.
And you, in your timeline of it all, can foresee, predict. You can calculate when and what impact certain things had. And say, it's such a vast scene now.
It's, I kind of always had faith in it, you know. I remember my dad saying, I think it'll be around for a couple of years and die out. Because obviously he's older, he's been through so many genres. And my dad used to love everything.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? He's got, I don't know, he'd be playing Live and Let Die, then he'd play like a Gregory Isaacs tune or something. Do you know what I mean? And it just is what it is. But so he's seen genres come and go, and maybe the violent media kind of thing that he got early on as well didn't probably help it. But then it kind of fought through that and it lasted. Do you know what I mean? There was a time where I think if he was playing like Powell in a rave, he was getting a fine. Like, that's mad. Like,
that's mad. Right?
Do you know what I mean? But I mean, when you look at the genre that's at, like not the genre, the music that's at now, that not every woman, but so many of them coming through, they're like half dressed, they're talking the most crud, like you got guys saying like mad things, like, and I'm just thinking, wow, like, I know it's a different time, but I think people have to be a little conscious in what they put out, man, because do you know what I mean? I don't know, man. Like, you can have a spider in a cage, and then you can throw in one ant, it's not really gonna damage it. But if you're throwing in like hundreds of ants, that spider ain't gonna stand a chance, you know what I mean? So if you're gonna throw out all that, that kind of negativity in a place where essentially all our kids are going to grow up in. Yeah. They're all going to take a bit of that. Do you know what I mean? Like, I don't know, man. Like, my kid was begging for, like, TikTok for ages before I even allowed him to have it. But his mum was like to him, listen, go and read up everything about it. And this is how she deals, because she's like an assistant head of a school anyway. And she's like, mate, like, she made him write out.
Yeah,
like,
she ain't playing.
No, she's not. Like, she gave man coursework on TikTok, you know. No, I was like, you know what, this, yeah, you know that. You know. And when he knew everything, wow. She's like, all right, cool, now I trust you with it because you know what it is. But a lot of people step into things blind that. And they're not really sure. Yeah, man, it's a different way of parenting, isn't it? Do you know what I mean? Some people got the naughty step or this or that and try and turn things into a lesson, do you know what I mean?
Yeah, and do it that way.
I thought it was good when she told me. I said, yeah, it makes sense, don't.
Yeah, it's blessed. The immediate comparables I think of when I think of 90s rap, for instance, or even 80s, I mean, we had to dig deep and do the research here to kill a kind of pop, so I'd say, you know what I mean? We don't just jump in these genres willy-nilly. But Two Live Crew, NWA, Luke, all these different rappers from back in the day that were brazenly saying probably the same sort of thing as Cardi B would say. What do you think the difference is, though, with this time around? Do you think it's technology? Do you think it's social media? Do you think there's more play to influencing?
I think back then the music was there and I feel like people dove into it if they wanted to. I think now, I just think a lot of negativity is pushed out, aiming at certain social medias, certain things like that. But like, everyone knows, isn't it? Like, if I put out a tune and I want to put an ad for a tune, I can age it between, like, so people between 18 and 25 see it. Or 20, do you know what I mean?
Oh,
and it's all that.
Yeah,
and you can do all that,
on
all the promo things and all that. But the thing is, with people want to get people young, innit? It's the same as any other company, like McDonald's. They got Happy Meals, man. Yeah. Everyone knows it's no good for them.
Yeah.
That's aimed at kids. If you get addicted to that, then when you drive past, you see the red and yellow or whatever.
Mum pulls out a wallet. Yeah.
And then you've just got them from younger. And no one wants to, like, start gripping pensioners because they might be around for 5, 10, 15 years. And then what's the point?
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? And when they're young as well, when you're old, I mean, you've got your bills, you've got your gas, your electric and all these other things. But when you're young, like, you got your mum and your dad.
Mm.
It don't matter what they have. Their aim is to please you.
Mm.
So you've got two different angles. And I think that's how certain artists come through and made it work. Like, Drake is probably a perfect example. He made music where women would go out and buy it.
Mm.
But he'd make music that men would go out and buy it.
True.
But a man could buy that also for his woman.
Yeah. But he also comes across as a bit of a melt when he's got two things trying to please everyone at once, isn't it? It's like, you know, that's okay. So you've got the girls choose, though, Drake. I rate Drake.
I'm not going to lie, I think he's cold. I like the early kind of like the mixtapey Drake. Oh, like
that overtune. Do you remember that? Stuff, I'm over.
I like all them sort of like July, I thought was cold.
Mm-hmm.
He's just good, man. He's good lyrically. Like, he's just good all round, to be honest.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? He's one of them people you can't really fault. A bit like a Beyonce, do you know what I mean? She's going to sing, she's going to dance, she's going to look good, but she's going to do it all at once. It's like, you just let her get on with it, do you know what I mean? Until she decides to stop. And I think he's one of those
candidates.
Yeah, man, he's good, man. He's proper sick.
Do you think they plug into the social media? I mean, they must do. The strategy behind every single campaign must be aiming for those kind of kids, aiming for the demographics to the wire, right?
Yeah, I think so, man. I think once something becomes popular enough, there's got to be a threshold. I don't know where it is, but there's got to be like a kind of a tipping point where once it goes over, it just floods and everyone sees it. Because there's songs that like, I don't know, like my nieces and nephews and that would listen to, and I'd think, like, what is that? But because I walk in three different rooms and I keep hearing it, no matter what kid's in what room, then now I know that song. But I'm not going to search that song. I don't even know the name of the artist. Like, I see two people on my snap yesterday was at a concert. I don't know whose concert it was. I'm flicking through. I've heard, like, three different songs. I'm like, I don't know none of this music. But then that might just be me being out of touch. Mm. Because if they can sell out like big arenas and that, obviously it's someone I should know, but sometimes I just keep away from things. Like, same if I want to write, I won't listen to anyone because I don't want to sound like that person.
Yeah.
So I'll listen to instrumentals or write a lot of my stuff a cappella.
Sticking with out of touch, though, it's that scarcity that social media thrives on.
Mm-hmm.
And the fact that you feel, it's a sense of FOMO. Like, all of a sudden, it's like, who is this person?
So, yeah.
That's a mad one, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's what I mean. It gets to that point and it tips over and then it's like a thing and now everyone wants to know what that thing is.
Mm.
Do you know what I mean? It's like Prime and things like that. Do you know what I mean? People...
Prime energy drink, yeah.
Yeah, everyone wants... Like, they see it and they're like, oh my God, this guy's selling it for this much. It must be sick. And then everyone buys it, but they don't realise all of them things. They're all tactics. It's all...
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Very much so, yeah. Flash in the pan kind of scarcity again.
No, if I bought out some dead hat and I was sending it for £5, people think if you're sending it for £5, it cost him £3 to make it. If I'm sending it for £400 and there's only 10 of them, people are going to be like, right, like, I want one of them, there's only 10. Do you know
what
I mean?
Where's that psychology come from? That is so bonkers, isn't it? That we'd rather buy some, you know, a Hermes belt for £350,
yeah,
rather than, you know, get this free download here.
Yeah, 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 yeah. It's nuts, isn't it? I think there's... I think it's that. It's because you're not paying for it. When it's free, it's like, I don't know, man. Things like, I don't drink tap water, for example.
Mm.
It's free. It's for everyone. Not that I'm down, like, putting a down on anyone that does. Whoever.
Peckham Spring. Stay hydrated, Peckham
man.
Spring.
When it gets hot, man, just do what you got to do, man. Trust me. But I just look and I think, you know what? If it's free, nah, there's something else.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? So, I don't know. Maybe it's that. Maybe it's like, that kind of mentality is just there. Maybe it's kind of conspiracy theorist type thing, or I don't know what it is, but...
Do you go down the conspiracy theory road sometimes?
Yeah, yeah, I love all that.
Do you love all that?
Yeah, yeah, I do. I love the fact that there's certain things that I would look at from a long time ago, and then when they happen, I'm like, well, it's not really a conspiracy then, is it? So, do you know what I mean?
When does it stop being conspiracy?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. When these things actually happen, I'm like, oh, okay, so is that...
Is that level of forecasting that you think, it's heavy as the crown on the head, isn't it? It's like you know too much and you can't call it quick enough.
I think for me it's more, I see it, I take it in. Like, I won't sit and watch the news and things like that. To me, it don't really interest me. I don't care what's happening, wherever, when it's coming from, like, from that. I don't know, I just don't really care.
Where's
like,
it coming from, kind
yeah,
of thing,
yeah, man, like, do you know what I mean? So, I don't know, I'm more... I try not to really... I just see things happen, do you know what I mean? If I see electric cars everywhere, then I know that, okay, if it's going to that, then the petrol and that's going to fade out.
Yeah,
do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's just common sense. It's like when you went from coal to petrol, the coal mine shut down because...
Yeah, exactly.
You know what I mean? So sometimes you don't really need to be told or to see things.
You just
change.
See the history and the fault lines and the patterns up.
That's it, man. Everything has an expiry date. Things last a certain amount of time and then they fall off. Hence why there's new genres of music or new... I don't know, like anything that's new. New directors making films. The old ones get old, they drop off, they die or whatever happens. Do you know what I mean?
When you look at like Shut Up and Dance, even what we said about Chipmunk versus Stormzy, there's cycles to these.
Yeah, yeah.
You got to stick with it. You got to be able to see it, haven't you?
Yeah, yeah. I think I saw something the other day. I think this is what it said. I think it was Jonathan Ross or something. And it was just something I flicked through on Instagram and I saw something and it was saying, I think he said to Stormzy, like, all that jumping up and down or whatever, you do your knees in, leave that to Skepta. But I'm thinking, I think that's what it said. And I was thinking, mate, like, you're saying that, like, Stormzy's old. Mate, like, how short are these cycles getting? Do you know what I mean? Is it 3, 4, 5 years now? Then you need someone new, you need something. Like... How's that going to work? How are you going to get the next Michael Jackson?
Yeah, yeah, it's true.
He was 5, 6, like, doing these ABC songs and that and going up until the day he died.
Mm.
He was practicing for a performance.
Yeah. That's all, like, he ever did.
That's all he did. Yeah, well, yeah. Do you know
what
I mean?
Do you remember, did you ever see the video where he's walking around in the supermarket? And
mate, I want that. And they're like, oh, that's like free. Yeah, I want it. Like, I don't care if 3 mil, 4 mil. Like, he just didn't care.
His life must be mad. Every time he turned around, there'd be a fan there.
Yeah,
and you know what I mean? And
he never experienced normal life. Like, he couldn't have. Like, when you get to that level of...
Yeah.
For me, he's probably the greatest entertainer of all time. And I don't know if that will ever be topped. In my lifetime,
I don't think
I'll see it, especially with the short cycles of people. Like, we're saying, you could have like a, I don't know, like who was young that was coming through recently, like a RD or something like that.
Yeah, that's right.
And people like that. And I mean,
well, they already tip him off anyway. Like, you know, who was the guy before? I mean, Devlin was there, you know.
Devlin was wicked, man.
If we're talking about
another
specific demographic,
another
sick lyricist, he's sick. You know, but before him was Example, before him was Plan B, before him was, you know what I mean? And it's an interest, and this is the thing about the UK music industry.
Yeah.
They love a good pattern. They fucking love a good pattern.
I mean, the thing is, if you've got a pattern, the work's done. Yeah. Like, if I make an algorithm where, like, okay, yeah, it's this, 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 and then now, it's only got to work the first two times. You're like, oh, okay, so it works, cool. Mm. Then I suppose it's easier to just sit back and just throw someone else in and just watch them go through it. Do you know what I mean? You haven't got to keep really updating stuff, I'm assuming, anyway, because obviously I'm not at the top anywhere, so I wouldn't know what they're doing up there.
But you're an observer.
Yeah, yeah, that's what it is. I just observe and I see things and I just see what I think it is.
You're the MC's MC, MC's MC, it's true. You know what I'm saying? Like, you're one of those candidates where people be like, oh, of course.
Yeah, wicked, man.
And Stormzy, Skepta more so with an international appeal, but like Stormzy, he broke the mold a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Now, correct me if I'm wrong, we're talking about Prince or Michael Jackson, Freddie Mercury, these kind of people for my age. You know, these are characters, like you say, that the mold rarely gets...
These are like legendary people. Like.
But were they breakthrough so far as... Well, they were. But Stormzy, when he breaks through...
Mm-hmm.
Skepta, when he breaks through, he's speaking for a different demographic. He's speaking to underprivileged. He's speaking to the unspoken. Yeah. He's speaking to people like us.
Yeah, yeah.
That, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
They don't know about the British kids.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
They don't know about... Well, how do we... You know, suddenly there becomes a mission brief, doesn't there?
Yeah, yeah. I think everyone, anyone in the past that's like... I think that's rap, grime, that kind of thing. I think that's what it's for.
Mm.
I mean, you can be a rapper and you can just floss and say, yeah, I've got this Bentley, I've got this watch, I wear these trainers. I mean, someone who's wicked at that would be like a Rick Ross, for example. Yeah. Like, I mean, I would listen to him just to hear him floss. I don't care about your political views. Just tell me how much money you got in your bank and how sick you are at telling that.
And how to be a boss. I mean?
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Like, he had an intro to one tune. I forget the name of the tune. And he's just laying on the beach. And the intro was his bank balance. Like. Mm. I'm just like, I was just thinking, nah, he's taking a mick. But... Yeah. That's good for what that is. I mean, there's music for everything. I mean, Spice Girls made absolute bangers. Do you know what I mean? Like everyone has different things. But I think when it gets to rap and grime and things like that, I think you'd be a bit like, unless you had the right angle. I mean, you couldn't really talk on upper class stuff, could you? Because if you was there, you probably wouldn't be doing rap or grime.
Yeah, it's true.
You wouldn't like you.
Can you probably sniff that out in grime as a professional in your field, can you sniff out when something's a dud?
I don't think there's many duds, to be honest. I don't think there is. I think a lot of people are... I think there's a lot of people that will say, oh, I've done this, I've done that, and they haven't. But, I mean, yeah, when it comes to, like, classes and stuff like that, I think everyone's... We're all from ends, isn't it? Everyone, everywhere is struggling, do you know what I mean? I mean, the only difference for me with Skepta and, like, Stormzy is one's North London, one's South London.
That's it.
But, I mean, they're both in a place where they can talk... from their area, like they've lived there, they've gone through things, or do you know what I mean? And people just go through the same stuff, man. People end up in beef, they end up in prison, they end up doing things to make ends meet, and like, do you know what I mean? Yeah. Single mums and single dads, and everyone has them stories, but it's who tells it the best, I think.
Mm. Authentication, isn't it? Knowing that you can't through the ranks.
Yeah.
And Pyro Radio, for instance, and there's a handful of others, obviously, for instance, Furman.
Yeah, man, pick up everyone everywhere, man. Pick up, like, Mode or even anyone, man, Mode especially, though, because I think I touched there a lot. Mode Radio London, man, if people ain't... Well, if you haven't heard of that, you're probably not a grime fan already, so...
Get in, Google that shit, come on, man.
Man, trust. There's people everywhere, though. I mean, but One Extra, I mean, big up Spyro, Kiss, you got New Kid, and everyone's trying to push something. Everyone's got a little corner covered.
Yeah. And I mentioned this to Sub 10 about the genre. We'll call it the genre of the radio because it really is.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's like its own kind of thing, isn't it?
For grime, it's blessed. It's so nice to, you know, it's reliable. And you get the new. You get something new.
Yeah, man. The radio side of grime, I think, is... It was just crazy important. It wouldn't have worked otherwise.
Mm.
I mean, when, like, a lot of people go radio now, they haven't got pay subs because, like, depending on the station you go on, it's the money is already whatever, or the DJ pays the subs and the MCs come through free. Mm-hmm. But back in the day, everyone that went radio paid £5. Whether you was an MC, if you had 30 people in there and you got to spit once, you paid £5 to spit once. Was what it was. And I think that like, you can pull £5 out, do you know what I mean? You can say, oh, even if you're going, oh, mum, I'm going out, she'll give you a fiver. Yeah, like, but when we was younger, 15, 16, people didn't have, like, £400 to probably press a tune and get copies made or and all them sorts of things. So I think the radio thing was important, definitely, then. Because, people had to come. They needed a place for Royal Rumble, do you know what I mean? Mm. Everyone had to go there and, I'm going to clash this guy, and the next time you're going to come back and have a livet for me, and I'm going to have a livet for your brethren, so now I can bring my brethren in, and do you know what I mean? And them sorts of things. But you know what? You end up getting... you end up just getting friendships and things out, stuff like that as well, man. Mm. Now, I'm from Newham, but there's people from Tower Hamlets and stuff that I'm cool with, people from all over the place, do you know what I mean? Like, I was in a crew called Blaze Them at a time. It was a long time ago. And we had a DJ called Thunder, and he had specials from, like, everyone, everywhere. Like, everyone you could think of. And then we'd have, like, Spyro on our show, or, like, All In One, or Teddy, or, like, Silent Arc. Just people coming from everywhere. There was DJs like Critical and people like that that don't mix anymore. But, people come, man. They're going to come with their MCs, and everyone's going to want to try a thing. And do you know what I mean? Full Flex crew, which was... Full Flex had, like, Temper T was in that.
Yo, Calibre.
Yeah, man, like, Vortex, Dark Boy. Mm-hmm. These were people that ended up in, like, Kids in the Hood, like, Crazy Titch, all that kind of side of things. There's people from all different crews that came from that, do you know what I mean? And Foxy was in Code Red with his lot, and his younger brother was in Full Flex, and he ended up going to do stuff with... Who was Foxy running around with? I think it was Johnny Cash at a stage.
Oh, big up Johnny Cash.
Yeah, man. So it's mad that we all just kind of grew up and everyone just expands and goes their own way and does stuff. But it was fun times, man. I kind of miss it, to be honest.
Yeah, I was just going to say, we'll go from what you miss to what you love now, but what is it you miss about that era? You know, age and wisdom, but you know.
Yeah. I mean, I miss the fact that everything was new. At radio, like, I listened to Bruiser, for example, once on radio.
Yeah, wicked.
A long, long time ago. Mm. Like, obviously, not once, I listened to him a lot. But I was sitting there listening, and there wasn't YouTube and things like that. And I'm thinking...
No Channel U, nothing like that.
Before all that. So, like, I'm listening, and I'm like, blood, I'm trying to figure out who this guy is. I remember him, I was thinking, he's a pub guy, white guy, bald head, probably a bit chunky. Mate, I couldn't be any more wrong. He was like the opposite of what I thought. But then it's like if you go to like a youth club or something, you're looking, you're thinking, oh, who's this guy? And then like they spit.
Yeah.
You're like, huh? Like I'll be thinking, is that him?
Yeah.
All of that stuff, everything was new. So anywhere you went, you'd find out something new, or people come in, you don't know who's who unless they got like... I remember All In One come to our radio show and I didn't know what he looked like. I was thinking, who's this guy? And I've looked down and he had All In One spray painted on his crepes.
God, that's sick.
So then I'm
like,
oh, okay, so that's you, to get me. And that's how it works. I like that, like the mystery side of things.
Curiosity.
Yeah, man.
Finding something like that you can delve into and really hone your identity with.
Yeah, man. And like I would go into like a record shop, I don't know, however much money I'd go there for score sometimes and try and get free records. I'd go there for £300-£400 and go mad. But, I mean, going in there and just picking up random vinyls, like, you just got a white label with, like, no sticker on it, and it's just there. I'm like, what's this? And I'll play it. I'll be like, nah, I've been listening to that tune for ages, trying to, like, do you know what I mean? I think it was Mondays. I think it started at 4. I think it was Rough Squad 4 till 6. Then Nasty 6 till 8.
Yeah.
And then Roll Deep 8 till 10.
Damn.
And then I'd go sleep when Too Tough Crew come on. Like, no disrespect to them, but I've listened to 6 hours of radio.
Six hours, you know.
Yeah, man. And all of that. And then, like, there might be one little tune and it might just be on a B-side or something because they don't think it's going to do well.
They just throw it on as an
extra tune. And I'm like, oh, yeah, I've got that. Do you know what I mean? So.
Oh, my God. You just conjure back so many memories, man. Just so many beautiful memories. Can you imagine, like, the whole idea, that lineup on a radio one day in a radio. Mm-hmm. That's a dream. That's like...
No, it was good stuff, man. There was a time as well where we was on, I think it was called Raw UK or Raw Blaze or something. I can't remember what it was on. And then I think Temptation was like upstairs in the same warehouse. So us lot and Full Flex used to go on at the same time. Mm. So then we would just spit and then run upstairs and special guest their show and then go. So we're all just running back and forth between each other's stuff and things like that, man. It was good.
Best.
I used to like that, man. It was good stuff. It was all right.
So good. The DJs make it happen. Big up Vic Siama as well. Whole type of Vic. There's a fucking load of DJs at the moment.
Mate, everyone, everywhere. Big up Selector Impact as well. Have I not even said that yet? Of course, man. Of course.
So what's the... going back to the original questions, what's the thing you love the most right now?
Now... I like the fact that people are not scared to have their own... angle. I don't think, because there's MCs been around for ages, I think there was a time where everyone wanted to sound a little bit like their favorite. Mm. But I think now people are in a position where they've heard everything for years. Mm. And now they're like, oh, okay, oh, so there's this pocket, or I'm a big man now. If I want to say, I don't know, I want to do this, then who's going to tell them they can't say that?
Mm.
Like Dark Horse has got a lyric where he says, I'm a big man, but still do errands for mumsy. Like, that's like, you know, years ago when you're 16, you're not going to say, oh, I run around for my mum. Like, mm-hmm. people, like, do you know what I mean? It's just not what you're going to put.
Yeah.
But, he's, do you get me? Like, he's a big man and he goes shot for his mum respectfully, as you should. Same way I do, way everyone else should. But you can say these things. And you've got people with, like, these angles, like Melvilus. He was a part of the Shelly Ann thing that I was in.
Mm-hmm.
That was Melly, SK, J Smart. There was loads of people in it. My
man,
brother, GL.
So you've done so much.
I've just been in and out of like little crews and stuff over time. But like Melvilus, for example, his whole angle was spitting, but on a godly one. But he's still going to come through and be sick. Do you know what mm-hmm. I mean? And be like, he'll go there and sometimes he's the best in the room. And I'm just like, and he's just spitting and he's just doing his thing. But he's talking about God. And how he wants to be a certain way and how he is a certain way. And like, do you get me? And it's mad as well, because how do you go against that? You don't. You just do your own thing. Mm. Let him do his own thing. Mm. So he's carved a lane where it's kind of untouchable, because unless you're going to come there with praise of like a different God and make it that, or bring him down for being godly, then how are you going to clash someone like that? It's a bit weird. You can't. And you got people like Bliss is a lot of respect for Bliss. He comes through, talks like, get me, he does that uncle kind of thing. Like he's good for the youth. And
yo, I love that. It's very self-aware, isn't it? That grime is very it's self-assured now.
Yeah,
it's of an age where it's like, you'd be surprised who is a grime MC.
Because
the way they get that, they've grown, they've matured into men and women, and moreover,
the
whole scene, you can have conversations about church, you can have
you can talk about whatever you want, and really no one's going to tell you that you can't spit about that. Do you know what I mean? The world is in that place as well, where a lot more things are open. A lot of things that were probably taboo are not as bad now. Like, people are just saying, oh yeah, I'm like this, or I do this, or do you know what I mean? Like, everyone's just got their own thing, so people just make music about it. I mean, it's a form of expression, isn't it? So same as like poetry or writing a book or anything, it's just expression really.
Yeah, it is, isn't it?
Yeah, it's good stuff, though. I like it, man.
You like it, don't you?
Yeah. Do you know what? It's one of those things that I just feel like, I wonder how my life would have been if I didn't really pay attention to music. I mean, I'm sure there'll be ups and downs. I'm sure I would have benefited in other ways, because I would have spent less time on it. But I don't know. Like, I spoke to someone before. I can't remember who it was. And they said they don't like music. Not a genre of music. They just said they don't like music.
What did they say? They don't like music.
Bro, I was thinking, is that like a soulless thing to say or something? I don't know, but maybe I'm not on that side, so I don't understand that. But normally I'll try to, I don't know if it's the Libra in me, I'll try and, to get me to see both sides of things and that, but yeah, I don't know, man. I can't imagine
I'm still gobsmacked, but they don't like music. Like,
bro,
what,
there's got to be something you like.
Lost sensories. Like, no.
Crazy, isn't it?
No, yeah, no spiritual connect or frontal cortex reaction.
If you like whistling or humming or the cello, or that, you've got to like notes in some sort of pattern. Like, for me, I don't know, I was stunned when I heard it. I'm surprised I can't remember who it was, because it probably threw me off so much that I was just like, blurred out for a sec.
Ah, best stay away. That to me, forget, keep that forgotten. But you never forget a good artist, do you? You know, you never forget, like, the moment you discover something. I mean, never mind the people that can't hear fucking...
It's
mathematics, man. you never forget a good artist, do you?
No. I mean...
Impossible.
Even out of the genres, man, there's just certain people I listen to and I'm just... Like, when I grew up, before grime was really doing its thing, I was listening more to, like, American stuff, maybe Busta.
Yeah.
I used to just like the amount of syllables he could write.
Busta's crazy.
His style and just the craziness of the dreads back then and all of that. It just added to the whole image.
Identity
and
the voice and everything. Just...
Yeah. Then there was, like, Styles. There was, like, the D-Block thing.
Oh, my God, yeah.
I was into that for ages. They're still, to me, probably, like, Styles is probably still
just
one of my favourite rappers.
Just no fucks given, just swag on a beat.
Yeah, whoa. Just cold. And you know what's mad? Imagine Sheik Luch is as sick as he is, yeah? And people compare... Styles and Jada, as if, like, imagine being in a crew where you're that sick and people forget to compare you.
Yeah, that's...
Like, he could be the main guy in another crew. And there was times where he was probably the hardest, like, the hardest guy in one.
Yeah.
And do you get me, man? That things that I used to listen to and just be, like, mad. I'd listen to, like, Luda and Missy Elliott for the video's sake. Like, the P. Diddy sides, like, the people with the money behind
you
them and that.
You Luda. Don't they?
No, Luda, yeah, they do. I think they do. He gets forgotten a lot, but he was definitely cold, man.
Yeah.
Maybe he just gets looked at more for the Fast and Furious thing now than that because it's a new age coming through. They see him as an actor. Certain people probably don't know he used to spit.
An old school actor. They don't know him as...
It's crazy. They probably don't know he used to spit. Imagine that.
Yeah, that's people, such a...
Yeah, it's nuts. I think now as, like, rappers, because I like lyricism, I listen to people that are just... Their wordplay's got to be sick. Like, I'm listening to, like, Loaded Lux or... Daylight, probably Kambata's probably, like, my favourite at the moment. Like, he's proper. Like, I listen to him and he makes me want to write and get better because I listen and I'm like, I'm not as good as this, so I need to be better.
But that's as good as when people just point music your way to discover. Anyone that shows you a new track or a new actor, you know, these are blessings.
Yeah.
But when there's an artist that genuinely makes you want to press stop, get a pen, get your phone, start... That's 100%. another level.
That Daylight Funk Flex freestyle, I probably listen to that maybe 30, 40 times.
Mm-hmm.
Like, and it's about 8 or 9 minutes long.
Yeah.
It's bare long. And he is just saying stuff after stuff after stuff all the way through it. And I'm just like, mate, he's scheming and doing all, like, little things in between and saying things backwards. And I'm just like, mate, how do you... Like, your mind is just... It's like another level, isn't it? You know, you got, like, 1D, 2D, 3D, 4D... It's like a different kind of level of thinking, but...
Spectrum shit.
Yeah, man. So I try and spend time in them sort of things. So I think that's one bad thing maybe with grime. The fact that it's 140, I could say some serious stuff, but people are not getting everything because it's too fast. I mean, there's ways to spit on it where you put less syllables in what you're saying, but then if there's less syllables, there's less words.
Yeah.
So I can't really say what I want to say.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I think that's where rap might have the upper hand. But a lot of the newer age ones, I feel like over there, they're kind of wasting that space.
Yeah.
By just saying
anything.
Yeah, man. Because what's rap like? What, 90 BPM, something like that? 100%. That's how you can kind of cross it over with the drum and bass because like half time with that.
Yeah.
Like that Nelly and Kelly tune, for example. I've actually got that on vinyl indoors somewhere.
Yeah, so that, you know, listen, I rate Nelly as well.
Yeah. I was going to throw him in when I said about Luda, because when I thought of him, I thought of him as well.
There's certain figureheads within the rap genre, the MC genre, which just don't get shine because they just... I mean, T-Pain.
Yeah.
If you want fucking T-Pain, there'd be no Soulja Boy. There'd be no Lil Wayne. You know, Kanye and Hulk, he just
Paper
reinvented.
Patrol album, yeah.
Yeah,
he
reinvented
was sick,
man. The whole thing. You know.
Definitely sick. I think because America's such a big place as well, you can tell like a Yonkers MC from someone down south and 100%. All that stuff. So I think, you can just go to any state and it has its own thing and it's like, what, 50 states, 52 states or something like that. It's insane. So over there, you can have the same genre done in just so many
just
different ways.
Yeah.
I think over here, obviously we got like, you got Birmingham, Manchester, you got like Nottingham. People like Window Kid and people like that. He'd have like his own style.
I love Window Kid,
mate. He's such a character.
Yeah, he's such a lad. Yeah, I love
Do you know what? Him and Snowy Danger.
Love Snowy. Why?
But them two just cracked me up.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I said to them before, they should give them a goggle box.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Them
yeah.
two together, that would be insane. Yeah. But yeah, man, like you got people from different areas, just like it's a bit different. And then within that, it's styles. So you got people like Prez T, for example. Yeah. You can't sound like Prez T without sounding like you're faking Prez T. Flirt of D, 100%. Maybe Monkey, D Double. Certain people just have their style, and it is just it's theirs.
You do.
Yeah, do you know what people tell me that as well? They do tell me that. I don't know what it is or what
it's
I do. I just
the voice, man. It's just so unique.
Yeah, I think. Yeah, it might be that. It might be that.
The voice, bro, like, sick.
It might be where I get the inspiration from as well. So because I listen to certain battle rappers and stuff, I try and have, like, a certain way that I'll put words together and things. That, and I try and be different, but without trying to be different. I just try and do me. Mm. But it just turns out that it just sounds slightly different, I suppose.
See, we're talking about bars here, you see. What's the future, bro? What's the future for you?
For myself? It's gonna sound really mad, yeah, because like I said, I don't really release anything, and then I don't want to be one of them guys like, yeah, watch end of the year, this, that. I'm not gonna do all that. Yeah, I'm not gonna do all that. But I live a lot in my head. I think up a lot of plans. I don't really carry a lot through, but that's something I've been trying to change recently. Mm. I've got a little bit more freedom now than I had before.
Nice.
In regards to all aspects of life.
We love freedom.
So yeah, man, you got to love a bit of freedom, man. Until yeah, we'll see what happens for the future in regards to freedom itself. But yeah, yeah, man, like the freedom I've got now, I'm trying to do certain things. So I meant to have a project coming out with one specific producer called Olja. Olja's sick, actually.
Olja?
Yeah, I've got, there's things, I'm doing little things and I'm going to piece it all together, but I have to leave something. I think because this is like the difference between me being like an old school MC and maybe some people looking at me as like a legend. If I was around the time, which I was, when everyone else was coming through or before some of people's favourites even was MCing, if I had just put out vinyls at that time or done things, people would still have them in their collection. So when Graham disappeared for a long time, that would be part of the history.
You're always, for
yeah,
instance,
do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, but I think now I need to leave something because obviously I'm getting older now. If I do leave it again, I probably won't be coming back to it unless because if there's like a 10-year gap, what am I going to do, spit when I'm like mid-40s? Yeah, yeah. I'm not really going to be doing that.
Well, you can,
but
do.
There'll be ways.
You
I mean, yeah, you can. I mean, there'll be ways to help the singing anyway. Like I did something before with Citrus, big up DJ Citrus, man. Yeah, Citrus. That was on the old mode where I just put out a tweet and I was just saying, look, has anyone never been radio before? Mm. Loads of people like, yeah, I don't know how to get on, People from like Manchester, Hull, Kettering, Newcastle, everywhere. And they're all like, oh, so I said, all right, cool. So I spoke to him and I'm like, look, if you don't want to come down, we've got a slot this day, this time, everyone can just come and experience it.
Yeah, yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Because that way it takes a bit of the station and brings it to them places, but it also allows them people to do something that they've wanted to do that they don't
concept.
Have the aspect for.
Good concept.
Do you know what I mean? Like they can't get to it. Sometimes it's who you know, isn't it? So if I know the people, just make stuff happen.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? There's times I want to do tunes with certain people, but I might have an idea and think, oh, this person will be better. So I might just ring that person and say, oh, have you ever thought of doing a tune with this guy? Because the styles might, do you get me? And then things link up sometimes and it happens, man.
That's a really good sentiment to leave on, the idea that anything is possible. And actually,
yeah,
if you conceptualise something and you've got the reach to do it,
yeah, man,
do
just
it.
Do it, innit? I mean, like, I think, what was it? I was listening to Jams earlier when I was in... He'd done like a Keep Hush thing.
Yeah, yeah.
And I was getting ready to come here and I thought, I ain't seen this shit. It was about 9-10 days old. So I've put it on and he was saying something about if you ain't, like in his lyrics, like, so obviously it rhymed better than the way I'm going to say it. But he was basically saying, if you've got something and you're not using it, then let someone else use it. Like, why not let someone else, like, better themselves? Why are you going to hold back something that can make that person better?
Oh,
when what does that say about you as a person? Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Just help, man. Sometimes, you know what I mean? I've got two bottles of water on me. If I don't finish this one and I see someone who needs a bottle of water, I'm going to give them that one. Like, what's the difference?
See,
do you know what I mean?
Yeah,
it's just,
man.
It's just basic things, man. Treat others as you wish to be treated and just try not to be a piece of shit, basically, innit? Do you know what I mean?
Well, if legacy and giving to the world is anything to go by, that sentiment holds true. And that's for the kids. That's for your
kids.
Yeah,
man,
that's
for everyone's
that's for
kids, man. So get me, after yeah, everyone's kids, man. Everyone, everywhere, and their kids' kids. Do you know what I mean? We have just got to be a certain way, and like you just got to try and live the life that you want them to grow up in. Do you know what I mean? We can't just sit there and moan about the life that's here now. You just got to just try and make things better. Some things are within our reach, some things are not. But the things that are within your reach, if you don't achieve them or do them, then it's your fault. Do you know what I mean? End of.
Real talk. Real talk.
That's it, man.
Shiesty, it's been a pleasure.
Bro, I don't stop rabbiting when I start, man.
I
but
fucking love it. That's what we do. Podcast, man.
Wicked, wicked, yo, man. Thank you.
Shiesty inside the place. We are like Inwards Out of Fashion. Killer Keller giving it to you once again on a podcast tip. Thank you so much for joining us, sharing this, caring, all right? You know what to do. Pass the message, all right? Crime don't pay, but neither do they. Don't talk to anyone I wouldn't. Stay lucky, people. Nice one, Shiesty.
Wicked, man. Big up, man. So, follow me as well if you can, innit? Yeah, that guy, Shiesty, you can get some whatever I put out. You see it, that's it. That with a D, DATGUYSHIESTY, that's it.
Insta,
all them things.
We're out here. Yes. And if you don't get that, Google that shit. Peace. Peace.
There you go.
Lovely. There they do.